welcome to the Rocket Report. Today, I'm here with Rachael Hartley and Coach Q at the high school to talk about cross country. And so just tell us a little bit about yourself and what grade you're in and how long you've been in cross country and running.
Okay, I've been in cross country for about 3 years now. I'm a senior. I've had a really good season. I've met a lot of friends through cross country. I also participate in band. I'm in PALS, NHS, student council, things like that.
So what motivates you to run long distance especially?
Well, as far as like being motivated, I think it just has to do with like the people in cross country. It's such a positive environment. That's the reason why I joined in the first place. And then I was like, also, I guess I'll be like getting in shape and there's a lot of health benefits, but it's really just the atmosphere of the entire team that motivates me to want to even like run distance and run miles after miles.
So Coach Q, you're a big part of creating that environment that she's talking about. So tell me, what things do you think that you do or that the team does to contribute to that?
I try to make it fun. I don't know, a lot of people would say running is fun. So, you know, I try to make it as fun as possible as I can. You know, trying different places where they run. I know over the summer we try to get out to like Cameron Park or Woodway Park so that they see different places. And I guess another incentive is we get to take them, you know, different parts of Central Texas. This year we also went up to Waxahachie and we, you know, different parts of I guess Central Texas to where they see different places, and I think kids enjoy that, to see different areas. And like she said, I think when you have kids that are positive with each other and kids that are involved in many activities like Rachael just mentioned, that makes it even better for them as a team.
So tell us a little bit about your accomplishments, especially this year and even last year if you want to, and what you think led you to be able to achieve those things.
Okay, so I've been in cross country 3 years and I've gone to state all 3 years. This year I was actually 12th at state, which was really surprising because I wasn't aware of that when I crossed the finish line. I also got third at regionals, which was a big deal for me because we have one of the most like competitive regions in Texas. And I guess just ever since like sophomore year district, I've just been trying to place and trying to motivate myself. And it's definitely the people around me, they'll like cheer for me. And it's not just that, I want to like set an example. I want to tell everyone that like as long as y'all work hard, y'all can do anything, because I just kind of showed up and I decided to work hard and I did well. I just wanted to show that other people could do that too.
So what do you think as her coach, what contributes to her success?
I think Rachael's very strong-willed. She's very disciplined. Again, I'm gonna mention the activities that she talked about. It's tough to juggle, especially as a high school student, many different activities at once. And she was able to understand those responsibilities. And if she had, I don't know, a band performance, she would get with us beforehand and get her workout in, because you know, cross country at the end of the day is an individual sport. Over the summer, we give them certain workouts because we don't meet every day during the summer. And she was able to do that on her own as well. And you could tell, because when we showed up for the first meet, she was ready, she was prepared. And I think a lot of that has to do with, you know, her daily life, the way, you know, she tries her best in everything she does in the classroom and out there on the course as well.
So what you were mentioning, some other accomplishments for her. So just to make sure we got everything that she's accomplished this year. Tell us about what things you had that she accomplished.
So back-to-back district champ, mm-hmm. Is that right? Junior year district champion, senior year district champion. She had her personal best at state this year, which was
11:54. That's close.
Yes. So that's her best time in all 4 years. She was also nominated and selected for the first team all-state team for a cross-country coaching organization, and so that's huge, because she's, like she mentioned, she was top 12 in the state, and I even want to say you were 11th, Rachael. I think she was 11th, but anyway, we'll fact check that later. that, you know, she's an elite runner. There's not very many runners in the state. If you combine all the classifications, you know, she easily is in the top 50, and that's huge because there's thousands of runners. So, you know, very proud of what Rachael has accomplished throughout her years here.
Great. So what's next for you?
I definitely am interested in running in college. It's just a matter of where. I'm looking into UMHB. They're D3, but they have a really strong cross-country team. I'm also looking at UT Arlington, which is a D1, and they're interested in me running for them. And so it's just a matter of like the nursing program and the atmosphere of the campus that I'm interested in.
Well, very good. Well, we are very thankful for you. Proud to have you and Coach Q as Rockets, and you definitely embody Rockets Never Quit and the way that you work hard, and so you represent as well. Thank you so much for visiting with us today. Thank you guys so much for listening to our interview with Rachael Hartley and Coach Q today. And then if you'll stay tuned, we want to make sure that we highlight some other fall athletic accomplishments.
Mission sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Liftoff on Apollo 11. All engine running.
Thank you, man. LMPD just increased a little bit.